The beginning of the 2019 NBA free agency got off to a hot start. Kyrie Irving, Kevin Durant, DeAndre Jordan, all members of the Brooklyn Nets. But what is next for the Brooklyn Nets? Where do they go from here? I think no matter what, we can all agree. On paper, the Brooklyn Nets have been the winner so far. Not only have they signed superstars in Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving, but DeAndre Jordan is a valuable guy to this team. Obviously, if you follow my channel, you know I have videos on why Kevin Durant and DeAndre Jordan are the best of friends. So I always knew that Kevin Durant and DeAndre Jordan were going to team up.
The main part of that deal was actually DJ, DeAndre Jordan, who may actually help them land Kevin Durant, whilst immediate speculation was DeAndre would get waived by the Knicks. Jordan, after all, is close with Durant, and served a similar role while with the Clippers in the summer of 2016.
It was basically all announced an hour before NBA free agency officially opened on Sunday, thanks to Woj. But to put it into perspective, they signed a former MVP, arguably the greatest player in the league when healthy, in Kevin Durant. They also signed an All-Star, a guy who was a past NBA champion and knows what it takes to win an NBA championship in Kyrie Irving. Plus, a former Defensive Player of the Year in DeAndre Jordan, who hasn't been the LA Clippers DeAndre Jordan, but has still been very, very solid. Which, let's be honest, it doesn't have to be a star player, it just has to be a solid contributor, and that's exactly what DeAndre Jordan will be in the Brooklyn Nets. And now with Brooklyn having an older veteran center like DeAndre Jordan and a young guy in Jared Allen, it gives the Brooklyn Nets a lot of options now, and it makes them one of the most interesting teams next season and for the future. This was a playoff team last season, but now the Nets could be primed for a huge run once Kevin Durant spends the next season rehabbing his ruptured Achilles tendon injury, which he suffered last season in the playoffs for the Golden State Warriors. We all know that, but 1 year off can make a huge difference for one of the best players of all time. Before I get started, I really just want to say a huge thanks to you guys for all the support, but I really want you guys to let me know what you think of this signing before I actually get into what I think. I want to know what you guys think first and foremost, because you guys honestly are the reason why I make these videos. I just want to have an NBA discussion below, so let me know what you guys think about the signing. If you're new around here, be sure to hit that subscribe button and leave a like for the next video, but let's get into this. The Brooklyn Nets have a very solid team. Well, they had a very solid team. Their depth is what made them an NBA playoff team this season and brought them from the ground up. They had guys like Spencer Dinwiddie, Joe Harris, Jared Allen, and now the addition of Taurean Prince, who is very, very underrated in my opinion. A two-way guy that no one is talking about. Not to mention, they also signed Garrett Temple on a two-year deal worth $10 million, according to Mark J. Spears of ESPN, and this guy is a nine-year NBA veteran, and a guy who could be a nice depth piece into the locker room presence of Brooklyn. He's a solid pickup option on a cheap contract and just adds to their depth even more. But in the end, is there a negative in going after DeAndre Jordan, Kevin Durant, and Kyrie Irving? Well, yes and no, and obviously it's Kevin Durant. Obviously, he's one of the greatest players in the NBA, but just hear this point before you start going crazy. No, tearing an Achilles is one of the worst injuries an athlete can suffer. We all know this. In the NBA, players have had injuries such as an Achilles injury and suffered for the rest of their careers. In KD's case, it will take about a year to recover, and for most players, their skills are never the same. His current time to return is around October of 2020, which is about 16 months away. Given the history of a torn Achilles, we have to assume that Kevin Durant will not be the same when he returns. He will be age 32, coming off a torn Achilles. But at the end of the day, this is Kevin Durant we're talking about. There is just no negative to this. This is a risk that you had to take if you're the Brooklyn Nets. And as for the New York Knicks, they weren't willing to offer him the max money, which is just ridiculous. Because with a guy like Kevin Durant, you just have to take the risk. He's a future Hall of Famer, a guy that could be one of the top 5 to 10 players of all time. Now, in saying that, an Achilles injury, we've seen players suffer, but we've also seen a guy like Dominique Wilkins, who has come back. He suffered the same injury in the 1991-92 season and missed just 9 months. Most players' performances decreased, but Dominique Wilkins actually increased. He increased his scoring from 28 points to 30 points per game, and he then played 7 more seasons after the injury, made 2 All-Star teams. Durant is turning 31 in September, so he'll most likely not return until he turns 32 years old, which is still considered a basketball player's prime, which is around 27 to 32 years old. Dominique Wilkins tore his Achilles at 32 years old, and he was far more athletic than Kevin Durant, and KD is a much better shooter, so even if he can't be as athletic, he will still be one of the best shooters in the game because that's what he is even right now. So I'm so optimistic for Kevin Durant, and I'm so optimistic for the Brooklyn Nets. But in my opinion, that is the only risk that they would face. Now, am I surprised about this news? Honestly, am I surprised that Kyrie Irving went to Brooklyn? Am I surprised that Kevin Durant went to Brooklyn? Am I surprised that DeAndre Jordan went to Brooklyn? Absolutely not. If you guys watch my predictions video, this is what I said. The 2019 NBA free agency predictions. Number 1, Kevin Durant. I believe that Kevin Durant will join the Brooklyn Nets. Number 3, Kyrie Irving. My prediction is that Kyrie Irving joins the Brooklyn Nets. Number 11, DeAndre Jordan. I do have a slight feeling that he could go over to the Brooklyn Nets and pair up with Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving if my prediction goes to plan. So my prediction is, if he doesn't join the Los Angeles Lakers, he will join Kevin Durant. So give your man some props, but no, I'm not trying to brag or anything, I'm just saying I wasn't surprised really because that was my prediction all along. But at the end of the day, when big name players come together as one, it's really exciting, and it doesn't surprise me, but it still kind of shocks me. But overall, you're here because you want to know what is next for the Brooklyn Nets. Well, let's look at their lineup from the starters to the depth. Now, it is worth noting that D'Angelo Russell, Shabazz Napier, Damari Carroll, Ed Davis, Theo Pinson, Graham, Rondé Hollis-Jefferson are among players that are not listed here who were on the team last season, but they are either restricted or unrestricted free agents, and it's most likely that none of them will come back. Before I get started, this is obviously subject to change. There's a lot of different positions that players could play. Spencer Dinwiddie may play the backup point guard or the shooting guard, we don't know yet. So this is obviously going to change, and also depending on who else they get in free agency too. At the point guard, Kyrie Irving, backup Jalen Hands. At the shooting guard, Spencer Dinwiddie with a backup of Joe Harris. At small forward, Caris LeVert with a backup of Taurean Prince and Garrett Temple. At power forward, Kevin Durant will most likely play at the power forward, and Kurucs will play at the backup power forward as well. Kurucs is very underrated in my opinion. And at the center position, DeAndre Jordan or Jared Allen, those are the starting and backup centers. But as we all know, this is really not the lineup, because obviously Kevin Durant is not playing next season, which leaves Kurucs as the power forward, and it does leave a little bit of an issue at the power forward position so far. So what power forward would they target? Well, with limited cap space now, it would be kind of hard to get a bigger guy, but a guy like Bobby Portis, if he comes on a little bit of a cheaper contract, I just reckon the Morris twins would be perfect. Trey Lyles could be another guy that they get, or possibly a guy like Jordan Bell from the Golden State Warriors. They may look to get him too, considering he was just a teammate of Kevin Durant's. A guy that would have been a perfect fit, in my opinion, would have been a guy like Thaddeus Young, but he's already signed with the Chicago Bulls, so I would say that one of the Morris twins would be a perfect fit for the Brooklyn Nets, and that is who they should go after and target. Because if they can get Marcus Morris, for example, they will have a lineup of Kyrie Irving, Spencer Dinwiddie, Caris LeVert, Marcus Morris, and DeAndre Jordan, with Jalen Hands, Joe Harris, Taurean Prince, Kurucs, and Jared Allen off the bench. That is a decent starting lineup, but a great bench depth. And to me, that is good enough to make the playoffs, but how far will they go if it's just Kyrie Irving and just DeAndre Jordan and a great bench? I don't know, because against teams like the Philadelphia 76ers, who just re-signed Tobias Harris, and they also got Al Horford, which is just insane, I'm not sure what I think about that as a whole. I mean, defensively, this team is very, very solid. Ben Simmons at the 1, Jay Rich at the 2, Tobias Harris at the 3, Al Horford at the 4, and Joel Embiid at the 5. Like, this is a scary team to face up against. The Miami Heat also traded for Jimmy Butler, and they're in the Eastern Conference, and you pair up Jimmy Butler with Hassan Whiteside and the rest of their young core, and it doesn't seem that bad. Although it doesn't seem amazing, don't ever count out Pat Riley to make the Miami Heat an even better team next season. I will make a video on that. You guys know I'm a Miami Heat fan. I made a bold predictions video yesterday, and I said that Jimmy Butler would end up in Miami. So as a Heat fan, I'm pretty excited. But all I'm saying is the Eastern Conference is improving, so Brooklyn's run to the playoffs may not be as easy as people think without Kevin Durant. And against the Bucks, who have Giannis Antetokounmpo, the MVP, and will only continue to improve, they re-sign Middleton and Brook Lopez. Like, the Nets will be able to compete. And don't get me wrong, they will challenge them. But I just don't know how much different it really is from the Boston Celtics and what they had this season to what the Brooklyn Nets will have next season. I don't know how far they will go until they get Kevin Durant back, is all I'm saying. In saying that, what is very interesting about the Brooklyn Nets now is they have trade assets. As much as I love the young players of the Brooklyn Nets, and as much of the young players as Jared Allen, Caris LeVert, Joe Harris, and Spencer Dinwiddie have literally brought the Brooklyn Nets from the bottom to the top, all these guys are now trade assets for the Nets, as harsh as it seems. I wouldn't be surprised if the Nets dangle these players as trade bait now or at the trade deadline or even next season's offseason for a star player to add to a big three alongside Kyrie, KD, and DeAndre Jordan. This is a huge year, not necessarily for the Brooklyn Nets, but for the depth of this team to prove why the Nets should keep these guys and prove why the Nets shouldn't trade for another star player in the future. In the end, Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant will be a great duo for years to come. The 2 to 3 year plan at minimum will be insane to watch. And in my opinion, this move will shape their legacies as NBA stars and future Hall of Famers. Let me know what you guys think about this in the comment section down below. Be sure to subscribe if you're new. Leave a like for the next video. Let's see if we can reach 2,000 likes and I'll upload the next video tomorrow. Be sure to hit that notification button and follow me on Instagram. I am out. Peace.